Croatia has been experiencing its own pound key metal moment, as women protest at being put through avoidable suffering and abuse during pregnancy and childbirth. Campaigners call it obstetric violence, and complain it has been going on for decades. But it was not until one opposition MP spoke out in Parliament about her own ordeal that a national debate started on social media under the hashtag #PoundKeyBreakSilence. Ivana Anisovic-Lesendrick described the medieval treatment she had experienced at the hands of medical staff after a miscarriage. They tied up my arms and legs and started the procedure of curettage without anesthesia. That means scraping the cervix, the internal organ, without anesthesia. Those were the most painful 30 minutes of my life, she told shocked MPs. Health Minister Milan Kujundzic suggested the story was a figment of her imagination. This is not how it's done in Croatian hospitals. You can give me your medical records if you want, and I will take a look. But many Croatians leapt to her defense, especially women, calling her statement bold and unprecedented. Croatia is a predominantly Catholic country, and many are reticent about talking openly about female reproductive health in what is still a largely patriarchal society. Pressure group Parents in Action, Rodan, which for years has tried to highlight the issue, followed up the MPS testimony with the Pound Key Break the Silence campaign. In one weekend alone, they received testimonies from 400 women, says spokeswoman Danielle Drandick. They duly handed them to the health ministry. We have reports of biopsies being done without anesthetic, of medically assisted fertility procedures without anesthetic, sewing to repair tears after vaginal childbirth, episiotomy being done without anesthetic, she says. Among the accounts were examples of abuse and women being talked to in a demeaning way during childbirth. Things like, if you could have sex you should now be able to take it. It was nice before and now the pain comes later, telling women that they are being sown to make their husbands happy. One of the 500 women is Yasmina Frulanovic, who still gets tearful when she recalls the humiliation and the pain she endured when she had to have her placenta removed a few years ago. They started the procedure without any explanation. The nurse was restraining me, she said. The health ministry says the personal testimonies collected by Rhoda were a relatively small number and are hard to investigate because they were anonymous. But it has admitted that certain differences exist among hospitals in the use of anesthesia, and that there is a need to improve communication between medical staff and patients. Both the health minister and the Split Hospital, where MP Ivana Anisovic-Lesendrick was treated, have rejected her account. A BBC request to interview Mr. Kujundzic was not acknowledged, nor was there a response to a request for comment from the head of the gynecology department in Split. Croatian gynecologist Ella Martin was not surprised to hear of the 500 women as accounts. Mostly it's not done on purpose. It was done like this for years, and people are not willing to change their habits. This is one issue. Another is the lack of time and the lack of professionals. When we joined the European Union, lots of anesthetists left the country because there are better working conditions in other European countries. For Danielle Drandick from Rhoda, The problem lies with women's experiences of reproductive health care, being viewed through a different lens from men's health. She believes that culturally there is an assumption that if a woman is going to become a mother, she will be able to take the pain. The MP who started it all in Parliament is delighted that the issue has been brought out of the shadows. But she knows the challenge now will be to keep it there. Right now, everyone is talking about it, says Ms. Nisa Vick-Lesendrick. We are talking about it and it's a big change. Now, we just have to find a solution to make this permanent. A poacher has been ordered to watch the Disney film Bambi, repeatedly, after he was convicted of illegally killing hundreds of deer. Missouri hunter David Barry, Jr., must view the film at least once a month during his year-long sentence. He was arrested in August along with two family members for killing the deer, taking their heads and leaving their bodies to rot. Prosecutors said, it is reportedly one of the biggest poaching cases in Missouri history. On top of the jail sentence for the illegal deer hunting, Judge Robert George ordered Barry Jr. to view the Walt Disney movie Bambi, with the first viewing being on or before December 24,
2018,
and at least one such viewing each month thereafter. During his spell in prison, the 1,942 cartoon about woodland creatures shows a hunter kill the mother of eponymous deer character Bambi. A month-long investigation, spanning several states, led to the arrest of Barry Jr., his father David Barry, Sr., and his brother Kyle Barry, according to local newspaper, the Springfield News Leader. While the total number of deer taken illegally is unknown, Lawrence County's conservation agent Andy Barnes said it could be several hundred. Barry Jr. received a year-long sentence in Lawrence County prison after pleading guilt to illegally taking wildlife. He has also been sentenced to a 1-to-0-day term in Barton County Prison for a firearms probation violation, and both he and his father had their hunting privileges revoked for life by the Missouri Conservation Commission. Two Scandinavian women tourists have been found dead in Morocco with kids to their necks. The country's interior ministry said both bodies were found near the town of Inlia in the High Atlas mountain range, near the foot of North Africa's highest peak, Mount Dabko. The women, from Denmark and Norway respectively, have not yet been named. A police investigation has been launched into their deaths. The Interior Ministry statement said, two Scandinavian women tourists have been found dead in Morocco, with kids to their necks. The country's Interior Ministry said, both bodies were found near the town of Inlia in the High Atlas mountain range, near the foot of North Africa's highest peak, Mount Dabko. The women, from Denmark and Norway respectively, have not yet been named. A police investigation has been launched into their deaths. The Interior Ministry statement said, the United States military says it has killed 62 fighters from the Islamist group Al-Shabaab in 6 airstrikes in Somalia. 4 airstrikes on Saturday killed 32 militants, and a further 2 on Sunday killed 28, it said in a statement. These were the deadliest air attacks in Somalia since November 2017, when the United States said it had killed 100 militants. Somalia has seen a sharp increase in the number of airstrikes and casualties since President Donald Trump took office in the United States in January 2017. A tally by the Bureau of Investigative Journalism reveals that at least 400 people have been killed in airstrikes since the beginning of 2017, far more than the previous 10 years combined. The latest strikes bring to at least 30 the number carried out in Somalia so far this year, compared with 35 recorded in 2017. The United States has a huge military base in neighboring Djibouti, from where it launches attacks on the militants. Mr. Trump gave the United States military greater authority in March 2017 to attack militants in Somalia, traditionally